Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm so sorry I've been off the radar. Like, I'm going to be showing you my new foundation routine, how I get this flawless, how I achieve this flawless canvas. You guys, I'm sure you're going to enjoy this. Like, I'm spilling the tea with the Maybelline Baby Skin Pore Instant Pore Eraser. So I'm going to be using the Maybelline Fit Mix buffing brush to apply my foundation, and I'm just going to go in with my setting spray just to spray some on the foundation. So now I'm going to go in like this. The good thing about this is that it's a drugstore foundation, but it does wonders. Like, using a buffing brush is also going to help you apply more products, and it's going to blend it out easily. Use a beauty blender to blend it, but the beauty blender is going to sap in a lot of product, so using this buffing brush is a good idea. My buffing brush just to make sure that everywhere is seamless and well blended. Guys, I don't want to believe that I didn't have any lightning on all through. Like, I think it's a lie. I'm going to be using the Black Opal True Color Foundation in Suede Mocha. This is what it looks like. I'm going to be using it just to go over the areas I want to contour. Allow the highlight to sit a little bit before I blend it out, so I'm going to have a more thicker consistency. Going with the Sasha Buttercup setting powder, I'm going to be using a damp beauty blender to set every areas where I highlighted. But first, I have to make sure that the areas that I've creased, I have to go back in, so I won't be setting a creased area. I'm going to begin with a True Color Velvet Finishing Powder by Black Opal to set the contour area of my face. I'm going to begin with my CoverGirl Queen collection in Ebony to contour the areas of my nose, my face generally. So I'm just going to be going with the Beauty Blender to blend out any ash lines. Next with my MAC brow set in Girl Boy for the brows. Just to put the brows in place. Next up, I'm going to be setting my face with my powder. Going in with the same ebony bronzer. Just going over lightly with the same contour powder just to give my eye like very little depth. So I'm going for a very natural look. With this black opal blush in Redwood, and I'm going to be using Glow Getter. I'm just going to pop that highlight down, just lightly, and in a blending motion. I'm using on the highest part of my cheekbones, and it's just going on areas where the light is touching, like. Can you feel the eye light popping? The difference eyelashes make a very huge difference to your makeup. Like, this is what I had before, which is nice. And once I got the eyelash on, I'll just go. Are you feeling this? It's exquisitely beautiful. I just did, like, I wanted to do a really, really natural look. Can you feel the highlight? It's not too much, you know, it's just in the right places. When the light bounces off on it, that's when you notice how the highlight pop. And that's the way your highlight is supposed to be. Like, it pops when the light bounces on it. Don't forget to subscribe. It's gonna be here or here. Like, thumbs up, and comment down below. Tell me the looks you'd like me to recreate. I missed you guys. Thank you so much for reaching out to me, to everyone that called, texted, sent me an email, or even, you know, just reached out to me. Thank you so much. I really appreciate you. Kisses and all.